Although, I don't know, maybe later. Maybe after a few beers I'll be rocking.
I'm sure you'll do that. Hey, what was the fastest speed you attained on your 27-foot Vega?
Well, I believe it was 164 miles over 24 hours, which is, I think, around 8 knots or so, roughly, over the 24-hour period. But I had the Guiana stream on French Guiana pushing me along. You can't do that on a Vega without destroying it, so yes.
Did you see any pirates along the way?
Every time I looked in the mirror.
This is going to be good. All right. You would think after 309 days you wouldn't have anything to say. So how was it going around Cape Horn?
Cape Horn is beautiful, by the way. There is a particular time, and if you can get there within the first 2 weeks of January, you have the most likely chance of not being hit by a crazy storm. Although I had many storms before and after, the day that I went around the Horn was a beautiful day, with rainbows and everything you can imagine.
That's a lucky day too, just like today. Did you get to talk to many people on the radio when you were out at sea?
I try to talk to freighters, but they never talk back. So, not really. No, boy, my VHF died, and so yeah. Once in a while, I could use a sat phone, but sat phone minutes are incredibly expensive. All the communications I had were all business related. You know, something about wind or boat or something breaking. So you don't often say, "Hey, how's the weather? What's up with this sports team and go Cleveland Browns and all that other stuff?"
Cleveland who?
I live here now, but I was born in Ohio. All right.
I think they made a trek here one time. Yeah. So, when you made the trip, were you aware of some of the people who have done this before you? Joshua Slocum, Sir Francis Chichester, Robin Knox Johnson, for example?
Yeah, Knox Johnson got a hold of me not long ago, actually, which is really nice of him. The first guy ever, he won the first around-the-world nonstop race. Of course, you spend time in the earlier days of sailing reading about Motissier and reading about Slocum, reading about these guys. But then you sail so much, you don't want to read about sailing anymore. You know, you just want to read about, like, the desert or climbing a mountain. You're in the ocean too often. But, yeah, all those guys are great. And I don't know, those are awfully big shoes to fill, but I'll keep sailing, so let's see what happens.
So you're gonna, your next trip going to be the Serengeti?
Yeah, I'm going to sail the Serengeti. There we go.
On a land yacht. Matt, I've heard from single-handed sailors, they get out there in the ocean and they actually have an imaginary boat that they're racing against. Did you have another boat you were racing against?
Oh, no, I would have lost. I was going really slow.
And at the doldrums, what was your slowest day run?
Backwards, 60 miles.
That would be a bummer. And the food, we talked about the food. Let's tell us a little bit about that. 800 pounds, 309 days. How was the food?
Shelf Reliance is freeze-dried food, and you get raw. There's Mr. Shelf Reliance. You get raw ingredients here and there. So you get corn, you get beef, and you just put it all together. And I mostly ate soups and stews every day because it's easy to do. But it's good. It's high-quality food. But it's not fresh food, but you can live off of it with a smile on your face.
We see you have a smile on your face. Look at him. All right, so you've completed this circumnavigation of the Americas, very strong feet, cheering for you all the way. My big question, what's next?
I need to get a haircut. You guys see this? Yeah. And a beer. Oh, well, I'd like to go back up to the Arctic and do another trip through. There's kind of one chapter that is yet to be written in the Northwest Passage. And so I'd like to complete that passage. But it's all about fundraising, of course, and it's a... You know, to get the money to get the boat and get the supplies and get this and get that. It's, but yeah, that's the idea, to head back up there. Shoot a documentary, too. So
I mentioned Senator Harkin a little bit earlier. I love modern technology here on the iPad. Here's Senator Harkin live. Tommy says, okay.
Yeah, I'm working on it. If I keep swaying, it just kind of stays in the same place.
Well, we'll go out on St. Brendan when you get a chance here. We'll go sailing out on St. Brendan. All right, Tom, will you bring the beer and I'll raise the sails.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you for sending it. Thank you for letting me know about it.
Very punk. I took a little notice.
Any racing in your future?
I do some racing out here once in a while, mostly with little Cal 25s because it's not very serious. I like to, I'm not very into going as fast. I'm just trying to get to A to B without breaking anything.
Well, how about this? How about on Wednesday night we crank up your boat and I'll come help you and we'll see what we do.
Hey, let's go for it. I think we can take them all, man. I'm confident.
Woo!
Okay, seatbelt. All right, well, first off, of course, there is a lot of risk in something like this. People might think, oh, you know, what he's doing is crazy. But no matter what you're doing in life, you know, reward lives in the house of risk. If you're not willing to risk, you're not going to accomplish. Everything takes hard work and sacrifice. It can be very difficult, of course, being out in the ocean alone day after day. But if you get yourself in the right mindset, it's not so bad. This is where I'm at. This is what's going on. I'm going to have a wet sleeping bag tonight and soup. Well, it's a good soup. But, and that's it. So you shut off parts of your brain like a horse with blinders. But nevertheless, you know, you have to work hard to accomplish anything in life. I would, of course, like to thank all my sponsors. I know if I try to say them all by name, I'm going to miss some. So I'm just going to say I would like to thank all my sponsors who believed in me before I left this dock, trying to go around to different places and call different businesses and tell them what I was trying to do and the expressions I get from their face. You know, I'm trying to do it on this little 27-foot boat. So yeah, I almost surprise me sometimes when they want to give me sponsorship. But I really appreciate it because without them, I wouldn't have got the gear necessary. And of course, without Don Backey and Crab, Don was the first guy. I was working on a boat doing a bottom job for one of Crab's boats, and I see a little. At the time, I was going to take a 25-footer, not the 27. This is the big boat. But I say, hey Don, why don't you let me take this boat up to the Arctic and we'll raise some money? And then, you know, I thought he'd kind of laugh at it, you know, and he said, yeah, okay, sounds great. So yes, he really, actually, truly believed in me since the very first day. And without Don's initial support and continued support, this would never have happened. And that's, you know, I am more than happy to help raise money for Crab. I think it's a great organization, involved with the sailing and a good nonprofit. And it's, my passions are nonprofit work and sailing. So it just kind of goes together for me nice and easily. We are, I believe, I heard, there were somewhere around 80,000. Now, the expenses of the trip were about 8,000, so I guess that makes us around 72,000. But once we get this match, we're about halfway to our goal. I believe that we're going to, you know, get a match of 21,000 from Godspeed and the Doug Kinney scenario. So, I'm happy. I'm happy to raise anything, and I think we're going to be able to convert that boat. Yeah, that's it. So, donate money to Crab.
Thank you, man. He's on live TV. Alrighty, well, Matt, just to conclude here, we were looking at your boat coming in, and there's some really good boat yards here in Annapolis. And maybe the bottom looks like it could use a little bit of a cleanup. All right, and there are also a few bars around that serve really cold beer. So I hope you'll partake on that. Anyway, congratulations. What a hero. We look forward to the book, the movie, and great success. Congratulations.